Hello everyone, this is Dr. Sam, and this is part 2 of chest x-ray lung pathologies. We have finished x-ray appearances of tuberculosis, pneumonia, and atelectasis in part 1. Now we will see more lung pathologies in this video. Pleural effusion refers to accumulation of fluid in the pleural cavity due to various conditions. It leads to formation of a meniscus, which is a concave line at the site of effusion. You will see this concave shaped interface between the lung field and the pleural effusion. The right costophrenic and cardiophrenic angles are blunt. In this image, the extent of pleural effusion is larger. The concave shaped meniscus is seen again with medial sloping. It is steeper at the medial side. Both the costophrenic and cardiophrenic angles are obscured. Here is a pleural effusion on the left side. We can see the meniscus very well, along with obscuration of costophrenic and cardiophrenic angles. Furthermore, pleural effusions can be best seen in a lateral decubitus view, which helps in diagnosis. Here is another image of left-sided pleural effusion. The meniscus is somewhat flat, but we can still see it. Subpulmonic effusion is a type of pleural effusion in which fluid is present only between the lung base and the diaphragm. And as you can see, the meniscus is not found here. There is no concave shaped line seen. The interface is somewhat dome shaped, just like the diaphragm. This feature helps in distinguishing a subpulmonic effusion from a pleural effusion. Here is another image of a subpulmonic effusion. There is no meniscus seen. It can be further evaluated in a lateral decubitus view. An empyema is defined as accumulation of pus within the pleural cavity. The opacity usually has a lentiform shape, which is a biconvex shape opacity. This is an image of an empyema in the left, middle, and lower zones. The opacity has a specific lentiform shape. We can see bilateral empyema in this image. Two lentiform shaped opacities can be seen, one in each lung. A lung abscess will usually appear round in both PA and lateral views. It will have gas fluid levels. That means there is air on one side and fluid on the other side inside the abscess. The abscess will have well visualized margins. Pulmonary edema is a condition in which there is fluid accumulation in the lungs' air sacs. It has a number of features on X-ray. One of them is Stag Antler sign. In this sign, there is diversion of upper lobe pulmonary veins, which resemble the antlers of a deer. That is why it is called Stag Antler sign. In the normal X-ray, we do not see such appearance over here. Increased cardiothoracic ratio is another feature if there is an association with a cardiac abnormality. You can see an enlarged heart. In peribronchial cuffing, there is increased density of bronchial walls, and these walls will appear brighter. You can see the walls of the bronchi are brighter here, whereas in the normal image, this is not seen. Kerley lines are a series of bright lines seen at different locations of the lung parenchyma. They occur due to edema. There are four types of Kerley lines, A, B, C, and D. Kerley B lines are seen well on a PA view. They measure around 1 to 2 centimeters and are found in the periphery of lungs. Kerley lines A and C are better seen on a CT scan, and Kerley D lines are seen in a lateral view. Pulmonary embolism is a term given to occlusion of pulmonary arteries caused by a thrombus. It has a series of signs which can be observed on X-ray. The first is the Fleischner sign, in which the pulmonary artery becomes prominent. You can see the difference in the density of the pulmonary artery. It is brighter than usual. Hampton Hump is the next sign. It consists of a dome-shaped opacity in the pleural region and it indicates lung infarction. In the Westermark sign, we will see focal radiolucent area due to collapsed vessels distal to the site of occlusion. Along with this radiolucency, we will see dilated bright pulmonary vessels as well. The Palla sign is another feature of pulmonary embolism. The descending interlobar branch of the right pulmonary artery appears sausage-shaped. This is another distinctive feature of pulmonary embolism. In the Chang sign, dilatation of the main pulmonary artery is seen. It is very bright, whereas in the normal image, it is not prominent and bright. Pneumothorax is defined as the presence of air in the pleural cavity. There will be absence of lung markings at the site of pneumothorax. We do not see any lung vessels here. Also, there is increased radiolucency in the affected side as compared to the adjacent lung. It is darker than usual. You can see this vertical line, which represents the visceral pleura. It is seen in many cases of pneumothorax. Here is another image of a right-sided pneumothorax. A tension pneumothorax will have additional features such as a mediastinal shift and a depressed hemidiaphragm. Normally, the right hemidiaphragm is slightly higher than the left hemidiaphragm because of the liver. But over here you can see it is actually a bit lower than the left hemidiaphragm. Emphysema refers to abnormal enlargement of air spaces, which is permanent. It is a component of COPD, which stands for chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. COPD patients suffer from chronic bronchitis and emphysema. On X-ray, the diaphragm will be flattened. The lungs are hyperinflated, which will make them appear darker than usual. There is increased radiolucency of the lungs and it is also irregular. Some areas of the lungs are darker than other areas. We will also see wider intercostal spaces. You can see the distance between the ribs has increased. This is another feature of emphysema. A saber-shaped trachea may also be observed. This is due to decreased diameter of the trachea. Bullous changes may occur in some cases. A bulla is a focal area of emphysema measuring greater than 2 cm with irregular areas. In patients with sarcoidosis, pulmonary involvement is common. It has 5 stages from 0 to 5. In stage 0, the X-ray is normal. In stage 1, it has a specific feature called the Garland triad, which has an enlarged right paratracheal lymph node and also enlarged right and left hilar lymph nodes. These enlarged lymph nodes will not connect with the cardiac silhouette. We can see the cardiac contours. They are not intermixed with the hilar lymph node opacities. These enlarged lymph nodes will not connect with the cardiac silhouette. We can see the cardiac contours. They are not intermixed with the hilar lymph node opacities. In stage 2 sarcoidosis, reticulonodular opacities are found along with bilaterally enlarged hilar lymph nodes. The reticulonodular opacities contain both round areas as well as linear opacities. In stage 3 sarcoidosis, we will not see enlarged lymph nodes. We will only see reticulonodular opacities throughout both the lungs. Stage 4 is the final stage of sarcoidosis. The X-ray shows numerous coarse linear opacities in both the lungs. It is a sign of pulmonary fibrosis. Lymph node calcification may also occur in some cases of sarcoidosis. It usually occurs in stage 4 sarcoidosis. Silicosis occurs when there is deposition of silicon dioxide particles within the lungs. Mine workers and tunnelers usually suffer from silicosis. On X-ray, we will see bilateral opacities and areas of fibrosis. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and stay tuned for more imaging videos.